What's going on, guys? It's Cheesy. Welcome back to another F1 2020 career mode video. Today we are going to be going to Monaco in the AlphaTauri. We had trouble last time here in the eucalyptus speed, so hopefully we can just bring home a good result for the team. Maybe get a couple places, but I don't know. If you guys do enjoy, leave a like on the video, consider subscribing, guys, and without any further ado, let's get into it.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Verstappen, Vettel, and the scientist. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. It's got to be a relief to qualify that far up the grid. How do you feel about this team's performance this season? Great. Well, that's everything.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Nelson Piquet once said that driving the Circuit de Monaco was like riding a bicycle around your living room, and it's not hard to see what he means by that. There's no more prestigious a Grand Prix victory than Monaco, but also none so challenging. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today, though, ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have the scientist, Bottas, Charles Leclerc and Albon, Hamilton, Ricciardo, Stroll and Sergio Perez, Ocon, Sainz, Kevin Magnussen and Gasly, Grosjean, Norris, Kimi Raikkonen and Antonio Giovinazzi, Russell and Nicholas Latifi. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. When you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
some wear on the MGUK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. This is your final lap of the race. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a good finish. Well done.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. So Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. After this round of the World Championship, Here's how things look in the driver's table. After today's performance, Valtteri Bottas secures the championship lead. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to the scientists. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern-day Formula One.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. Another podium. You must be getting used to it up there. We all underestimated you, didn't we? Things were close between you and your rival, but it looks like you're coming up top, doesn't it? Appreciate your time.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through from the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.
Alright guys, so finished up that Grand Prix. Had a nice finish. Podium finish, second place. Not bad. I think we're getting momentum here, getting the hang of this thing, and I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, you guys want to leave a like on the video, consider subscribing, that would be great. Next time we're going to be going to Azerbaijan, a fun track, a fast track, and we're going to see what we can do. So guys, until next time, peace.